टाकेत नंबर ने कैमरा है ना काम
हाँ है क्या
कवरेज
स्टार्ट है।
गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज माय सेकंड डे एंड नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू द बेसिक्स ऑफ इंग्लिश एंड यस्टरडे आई टॉट यू ऑल द पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच। How many parts of speech are there? 8, right? There are 8 parts of speech. Let us recollect what happened and what I taught yesterday. There are 8 parts of speech. They are noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. These are the 8 parts of speech. And in today's class, I'm going to teach you about the kinds of sentences and what a word is and what a phrase is and what a clause is and what a sentence is. See, language is nothing but sounds, different kinds of sounds. They give different meanings. English derived from Latin, and they are all European languages. And English was derived from Latin, and Latin is also like a Sanskrit. Nowadays, Sanskrit is not being used, right? And nobody speaks Sanskrit nowadays. In the same way, Latin is not spoken in Europe, but English derived from Latin, the European language. And in the coming classes, I tell you in depth about how a language born and different kinds of languages and their roots, and from which it was born like that. For example, take in India. Most of the languages spoken in India divided into different groups, but mainly two groups. There are Aryan languages and Dravidian languages. Dravidian languages are nothing but Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayalam. These are the Dravidian languages. All these South Indian languages derived from old Tamil. Surprising. Telugu has come from Tamil. Kannada, Telugu, Malayalam, they all came from old Tamil. There is no connection between Telugu and Sanskrit. Some words are included in Telugu from Sanskrit, but Telugu came from old Tamil, not the present Tamil, old Tamil. So all the languages spoken in South India, that is Southern Indian languages, derived from old Tamil. In the same way, the North Indian languages, Bengali, Punjabi, Gujarati, Hindi, Uriya, and all Marathi, all these languages are derived from Sanskrit. They came from Sanskrit. So it is a changing process. Anyway, any language is nothing but sounds. They give different sounds, and for each sound, one letter is used. So in any language, the alphabets are known as the letters, right? And they give different sounds. Let us come to English. How many alphabets are there in English language? 26, right? There are only 26 alphabets in English language. What about Telugu? How many alphabets are there in Telugu language? 56. Okay, 56. See, in Telugu language there are 56 alphabets, but in English there are only 26. English is very easy, you know, when compared to any other language, English is very easy because the way we write English alphabets are very easy when compared to writing Telugu or Hindi alphabets. In Telugu alphabets and in writing Hindi alphabets, it is very difficult to move our pen, right? Because it moves around and it moves to and fro, something. But writing English letters is very easy. It's very easy. And not only in writing, learning English is also very easy because words are also limited. If you learn just 500 words in English, you can understand English, you can speak in English very easily. And I will tell you how to learn very easily, and you can teach your younger brothers, younger sisters, and you can teach your parents in case of needed. So it is very easy to learn English language. Let us see the alphabets. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. These are the English alphabets, right? But these alphabets are written in four different styles. Why? Because two different styles are meant only for printing. Only for the purpose of printing, two types of letters are used. For writing, we use the remaining two types of letters. See, for example, let us take A. This is used for printing. This is printing capital letter. And this one, this is a printing small letter. See, you never use this kind of A in writing. This is meant for only writing. And when we write, we should not use this A. We should use this A. This is capital A, and this is small A. So these two are meant for printing, and these two are meant for writing. So whenever you write, you have to use only these two types of letters. For example, I am going to write only till D, A, B, C, D. This is not E, this is only C. This is a capital C. And a small A, B, C, D. These are small A, B, C, D, and these are capital A, B, C. And if printing capitals are like this, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. So these are the four kinds of letters. The first two kinds of letters are meant for printing, and these two, the remaining two types of letters, are meant for writing. So whenever you write, use only these two. Okay, when you put title, when you write the title of a story, when you put the heading of something else that you write, sometimes you can use this one, but that is not suggestible. We have to use only these two. Okay, this is about different types of letters in writing. And and these 26 letters are divided into two groups. They are vowels and consonants. What are they? Vowels and consonants. Vowels, V-O-W-E-L-S, vowels. Vowels are five. They are A, E, I, O, and U. A, E, I, O, and U are called vowels. The remaining letters are called consonants. How many consonants are there? 21. See, the total number of letters in English alphabet are 26. When 5 out of 26 are vowels, the remaining 21 letters are consonants. Vowels are very important. A, E, I, O, U are very important because we can't pronounce a word. We can't pronounce a word without vowel letter. Frankly speaking, not letter, sound. There, sound is important, not the letter, not the physical letter. Sound is important. And each letter in English alphabet gives different sounds. For example, letter A gives five different kinds of sounds. And like that, each letter gives different kinds of sounds. And the sounds of letters are known as this is a special name, that is phonetics. Under the subject phonetics, you learn the sounds of each letter. And you'll have a question. You'll have a question in class 10 and senior intermediate on phonetics. Phonetics, right? You should know where to stress. You should know where to stress and where to give much stress on the letter. So you'll learn. And these are the vowels and the remaining letters. What are the remaining letters? B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. So these the remaining letters are known as consonants. They are 21 letters. Okay. Vowels are very important. Why? Because we can't pronounce a word without the help of vowel sound. Vowel sound. And if you observe any word in English, you can see a vowel in it. Yeah, you can see a vowel in it. See, for example, bat, a small word, bat, B-A-T, bat. And which is the vowel in it? A. A is the vowel. Can you pronounce without A? Can you pronounce this B and T without a vowel? No, it's not possible. So, vowels are very important to pronounce a word. Okay, and in dictionary you can see them. You can see, and this is a small word, and it has only one syllable. Syllable, S Y L L A B L E, syllable. What is a syllable? Syllable is a part of a word in which there is a vowel sound in it. See, for example, take this handsome, H A N D S O M E, handsome. What is the right pronunciation of this word? Handsome. D is not pronounced. D is silent. It is a silent letter. When a letter is not pronounced in a word, then the letter is known as silent letter. So D is silent in the word handsome. In this word handsome, there are two syllables. And ham is one syllable and some is another syllable. See, in hand, which is the word here? A. A is the word. And this is one syllable. And in this syllable, well is there. So syllable is a part of a word in which there is a verb. And some is another syllable, and there are two words in it, O and E. Some is another syllable. So how many syllables are there in the word handsome? Two. What are they? Handsome. And let us take another example. Beautiful. Beautiful. B-E-A-U-T-I-F-U-L. Beautiful. If you look at the word beautiful, let us try to divide the word into syllables. Beautiful. 1, 2, 3. There are three syllables in the word beautiful. Beautiful. In beau, what are the words? E, A, U. And in T, I. And in full, U. If in the syllable full, just remove U and try to pronounce it. No, you can't pronounce. So vowel is such an important letter in a syllable, which makes it possible to be pronounced full, T. Okay. In handsome, two syllables, and in beautiful, there are three syllables. What is a syllable? Syllable is a part of a word in which there is a vowel, letter, or a sound. Okay. And what is a letter? Letters are nothing but some sign which gives a sound. And there are 26 letters in English. Alphabet. Alphabet is nothing but the letters of a particular language. Okay. And so far we have learnt about the four different kinds of letters and vowels and consonants, and how many vowels are there, what are they, how many consonants are there and what are they. We have learnt them so far. Okay. And we have also learnt about syllable. Okay. Now let us go to a word. What is a word? See, A is a letter, B is a letter, C is a letter, D is a letter. What is a letter? What is a word? If there are some letters in a word and which gives us some sense means meaning. If some letters all together give some meaning, then it is known as a word. See, in some words there is only one letter. What is that? Find out. That is a bat, a cat means one cat, a bat means one bat. So, this is not pronounced as A, This is pronounced as a. A means one. A cat means one cat. A bat means one bat. So what is the meaning of a? One. So when A is used to give the meaning of one, then it should be pronounced as a, not as a. When you read out the alphabets, then you have to read them as ABCD, not RBCD. Everybody will laugh at us if we read out them like RBCD. Okay. So when it is used as an article, when it is used to give the meaning of one, then we should pronounce it as a. Okay, so this is a verb. Even though there is only one letter in it, but it's a verb because it gives some sense, it gives some meaning. And an egg. Egg, not a egg, an egg. Why? Because the word egg begins with vowel sound. Whichever word that begins with the vowel sound, then it takes an before it. An apple, an egg, an ice cream, an owl. Like that. So they are known as articles. What are they? A and the. These three words are known as articles. And when we are going to learn about articles, then I'll tell you more about a and the. So in here we are learning only what a word is. So a word means a group of letters which has some sense, which has some meaning. That is known as a word. And what is a phrase? We have just known what a word is. If there are more than one word and give some sense, give some meaning, then that is known as phrase. For example, there must be more than one word. See, for example, in front of, I am standing in front of a camera. In front of, there are three words in this phrase. In front of, there are three words, and this type of thing are known as phrases. So if something has more than one and which gives some meaning, then that is known as phrase. Okay. And according to, beside of, these are all phrases. And now let us see class. There is no much difference between a clause and a sentence. You know very well what a sentence is, right? Sentence must begin with a capital letter, must end with a full stop or a question mark, an exclamation mark, right? That is a sentence, right? But clause is only a part of a sentence. That is the only difference. Sentence gives us a complete sense. A sentence gives us complete meaning. Whereas a clause is only a part of a sentence. Class also gives us meaning, complete meaning, but it is only a part of a sentence. See, for example, though I studied well, I failed. Though I studied well, I failed. Though I studied well is one class, I failed is another class. And these two class is known as a sentence. What is the sentence? Though I studied well, I failed is a sentence. In this sentence, there are two classes. Though I studied well is one class, I failed is another class. And there are different types of classes. So, class and sentence. There is very less difference. Class is only a part of a sentence, and it also gives complete sense like sentence. Next, if we go to the sentence. Sentence gives us a complete meaning. Sentence gives us complete sense. A sentence must begin with a capital letter and must end with any punctuation mark like full stop, exclamation mark or question mark. These are sentences. What are the rules of a sentence? A sentence must begin with a capital letter and must end with full stop or question mark or exclamation mark. So this is the sentence. And for example, I am standing is a sentence. And this sentence must begin with a capital letter. I am standing. Okay, the pen is there's no ink in it. Okay, I am standing. I, as it begins with I must be written as a capital letter. Okay. And there are four kinds of sentences. They are declarative or assertive, and number two is imperative sentence, and number three is exclamatory sentence, number four is interrogative sentence. These are the four kinds of sentences, and each kind of sentence must end with a different punctuation. Full stop is put at the end of declarative or assertive sentence, and also at the end of an imperative sentence. And the same way, interrogative sentence must end with an interrogative mark, that is question mark, and exclamatory sentence ends with exclamation mark. So these are the four kinds of sentences. So far we have learnt what a letter is and how many letters are there in English alphabet, and from which language English has been derived, and the groups of English alphabet. There are two groups, that is vowels and consonants, and what vowels are, and what are the letters in the vowels, and how many are there. And we have also learnt about consonants. How many consonants are there? What are they? So other than A, E, I, O, U, all letters are known as consonants. Okay. And we have also learnt about what a word is, what a phrase is, and what a class is, and what a sentence is. So in this class, you have learnt kinds of sentences, and what a sentence is, and what a class is, and what a phrase is, and what a word is, and what a letter is, and what are vowels, what are they, and what are consonants, and what are they. And you have also learned that each letter in English alphabet gives different kinds of sounds. For example, the letter A gives 5 different kinds of sounds. I'll tell you, don't worry, I'll tell you. In the coming classes, I'll tell you everything in detail. And there are some signs, for example, question mark. Question mark is used to put a question, to ask a question, and it is used at the end of an interrogative sentence. And exclamation mark is a straight line. Look at my hand, what I'm writing, a straight line and a dot below it. This is known as exclamation mark. And exclamation mark is put at the end of an exclamatory sentence, and it is used to exclaim. Exclaim means to tell something in wonder. Maybe any kind of feeling, but it is a sudden feeling. That's where it is known as exclamation. Wow! What a beautiful bird it is. Peacock. When it dances, it looks very beautiful, right? Peacock. And peacock. Wow! What a beautiful peacock it is. And we put exclamation mark at the end of the sentence. What a great animal it is. How faithful you are. You are talking to your dog. And you are praising your dog. And you are appreciating your dog. How faithful you are. At the end of that sentence, how faithful you are, at the end of that sentence, you put an exclamation mark. India is great. It is a normal sentence, right? Even though it is a normal sentence, depending on the way we express it, we have to put the mark. Whether to put full stop or whether to put exclamation mark. See, for example, look at me. India is great. I am talking in general. India is great. But I am expressing it with a kind of feeling. So these type of sentences are known as exclamatory sentences. How great India is. What a great country India is. India is great. All these three sentences are known as exclamatory sentences. Though India is great, it seems to be declared a sentence. But depending on the way of expression, we say that it is an exclamatory sentence. So expression is important. When you put a question, will you ask like this? What is your name? No. You should pronounce it as a question, that you put a query. What is your name? What is your name? So seeking information. So, depending on the sentence, we have to change our facial feelings. We have to change the way we speak. So, sound is very important. That's why you must learn different kinds of sounds. You must be very well in phonetics. You must understand, you must learn the different sounds that gives the different types of letters gives the different sounds, right? You must learn all this. And in very good dictionary, the sounds are there. and for each sound there is a symbol. So depending on the symbol, we pronounce them. So you have to learn the symbols and which symbol gives which pronunciation. You have to learn all these things. And you must look at the dictionary at least once in a day. And you must learn at least 5 new words every day. And 1 grammar point each day. So that is the way to learn any language. Don't worry, learning English is not at all a difficult task. It is very easy. Okay. So I am going to conclude today's class. What I have taught you, I have taught you how many alphabets are there, what are they, and different kinds of letters, vowels and consonants, what are vowels, and how many are they, what are consonants, how many are they, and what is a word, and what is a phrase, and what is a class, and what a sentence is, and different kinds of sentences. So in this class we have learned all these things. Okay, and tomorrow most interesting topic I'm going to tell you. Okay, so don't miss my class. Please do watch my class. Keep watching. Whenever you get a doubt, you can go back to it and you can watch it again. Okay, thank you, bye.